During the 1940s, it was recognized that bacteria had conventional genes like higher organisms. This prompted many researchers to begin investigating the mechanisms of heritability in bacteria, giving rise to the field of bacterial genetics and overhauling numerous erroneous beliefs. One such belief was that bacteria were a purely clonal domain of life, only capable of reproducing by fission. However, this was toppled by Joshua Lederberg and Edward Tatum in their 1946 paper, Gene Recombination in Escherichia coli. These researchers investigated whether bacteria had a sexual process, something that hadn't been conclusively proven but could theoretically be detected by finding novel genotypes in a mixed culture of two genetically diverse strains. The experiment they devised to detect a sexual process was to grow complementary triple-nutritional organotypes in a mixed culture, which should yield prototypes if genetic recombination could occur. The use of triple organotypes nullified the possibility of spontaneous mutation giving rise to prototypes, as he must have mutations at three loci to spontaneously revert to full prototropes, which doesn't occur at a measurable rate. To create triple auxotrophs, K12, a wild type of coli strain, was repeatedly exposed to X-rays and UV light to accrue multiple nutritional deficiencies. This resulted in Y10, an auxotroph for threonine, leucine, and thiamine, and Y24, an auxotroph for biotin, phenylalanine, and cysteine. Three flasks were prepared, containing broth that supplemented all the nutritional requirements that Y10 and Y24 needed to grow. As a control to ensure prototrophic reversion wasn't spontaneous, two of the flasks were inoculated with pure cultures of Y10 and Y24, whilst in the third, both strains were added so the auxotrophs could exchange and recombine their genes in the hypothesized sexual process. After bacteria were given ample time to grow and interact in the flasks, they were plated on minimal agar to select for prototrophs. After 2 days, growth was found on the mixed culture plate, meaning some bacteria in the mixed culture had undergone full reversion back to wild-type prototrophs. This reversion wasn't spontaneous, as neither of the pure batches grew, meaning the E. coli must have undergone genetic recombination. In addition to prototrophs, other novel genotypes were isolated from the mixed culture, such as auxotrophs for only one growth factor and double auxotrophs with a combination of parental deficiencies, providing further evidence that recombination had occurred. The researchers also examined the heritability of non-selected for factors into recombinant progeny by inducting T1 phage resistance into one of the auxotrophs and repeating the experiment. Both phage-resistant and susceptible prototrophs were obtained, showing that segregation of this trait occurred. However, it was reported in later work that the ratio of resistant to susceptible prototrophs wasn't equal, as it should be for an unlinked trait, and was relatively constant. This led to the finding that genes were linked on a chromosome, which allowed Lederberg to construct the very first partial maps of the E. coli chromosome. The researchers postulated that the only ways that genes could be brought together for recombination were either cell fusion or transformation. Wishing to disprove the latter, the field trait from a culture of double auxotrophs, threonine and proline, was obtained, which contained transforming factors, or DNA, and a complementary auxotrophic strain for methionine and biotin was grown in its presence to try and initiate transformation. Had transformation been the mechanism of gene transfer and recombination, this should have yielded prototrophs. However, none were isolated. This ruled out transformation as the mechanism of gene transfer, so researchers were confident that they had discovered an analogue to sex in bacteria. The researchers initially thought the bacteria fused to form a diploid zygote, from which recombinant bacteria arose. However, the horizontal gene transfer mechanism they actually discovered was conjugation, and Y10 and Y24, which were later found to be HFR cells, were forming pores through which either bacteria could copy its chromosome into the other, briefly producing a diploid cell in which recombination between chromosomes could occur, and from which recombinant bacteria, such as prototrophs, arose. To summarize, gene recombination in Escherichia coli demonstrated that a sexual analogue existed in bacteria, toppled the foundational belief of the era that bacteria were purely clonal in nature, and led to the discovery of conjugation. The discoveries and methods for bacterial genetic analysis developed in this paper formed the basis for many significant works, including studies of the kinetics of gene transfer and conjugation, which produced maps of the E. coli chromosome and found it to be circular. Gene recombination in Escherichia coli was one of, if not the, most influential paper in bacterial genetics.